Hey everyone, John here. Welcome back to another tutorial. Continuum 2024.5 is out and it includes the brand new Color Link effect. And being a long-term, many years fan of the Color Link effect in After Effects, I was super excited to see this included. And I think I'm the perfect person to walk you through how I think this is going to help your workflow as it helps mine. So let's jump in. Color Link is a really simple effect. You use it to take the color or a sample of color from one layer and apply it to other layers. And in this shot, I've got a range of different layers inside a pre-comp, and I've already applied the Color Link effect, which I'm going to turn on. Now, at its default settings, it's using as a sample layer itself, okay, this split screen footage comp. Now, I want to sample source one, which is this pink shot. So if I choose that as a sample, now you can see everything goes this sort of pink tone. And the sample method is set to average, and that's why we get that look. You can choose different sample methods depending on the shot you're applying it to and also the shot you're sampling. And you've got a sample type of dynamic or static. So here at dynamic, it's using all the frames of the footage that I'm sampling. If I chose static, then at its default, it would only sample frame one. So you can choose a frame to sample. I'm going to keep mine on dynamic. With this shot, it doesn't really matter because it's pink all the way through. Sample region, here it's sampling full frame by default, so it's going to sample the entire frame. If I wanted to sample a specific region, I could choose point radius, and I could click, so if I wanted to choose this light for some reason. And now it goes much brighter because it's sampling around that light area. I can control the size of the sample by adjusting this radius amount. So as I bring that down to zero, it's sampling much closer to this effect control point. So it's actually not getting much pink at all. So here I'll just choose full frame. You can knock that back a little bit by just adjusting the opacity if you only want a little bit of colorization. And you can, of course, choose different blend modes. So there's multiple different blend modes to choose from. And once again, the one you choose would depend on the footage that you're applying it to and the shot you're sampling. It's at soft light by default because this is probably one of the ones you'll use the most. Now, beneath that, we have film glow. I'm going to talk about that in a moment. You also have color correct, which is very handy. And this is something that Color Link in After Effects doesn't have. And I like it because if I use something like, let's go overlay, which is a little strong, then I can use color correct just to dial that back. You know, I could go into the individual channels. I could pull out some of the magenta, pulling in some cyan if I wanted to. Change the color temperature, the gamma. And with this shot, maybe bringing out some of the saturation and, you know, increasing the brightness. So you can use different blend modes and then dial in the final look using color correction. I'm just going to turn that off and choose soft light again. And there's a drop shadow option as well, but that's more used for things like text. I'm just going to twirl that up. Right down the bottom, we've got mix with original. So you've got a final option to mix all of the settings above, including film glow, color correct, and drop shadow, in with the original shot. So lots and lots of different options to choose from. Let's choose a different sample layer. Source 2. Now it's gone yellow, and that's because this shot is more yellow. We also have source 3, which is some fire. And this is a little different from the other shots because there's obvious motion in there. And it's really nice because you can see, especially on this shot here, you might be able to see it on the video, you're getting a bit of sort of flicker in the shot because it's sampling this dynamically, and it's got some bright areas and some dark areas of orange which are reflected in the shot. If we maybe choose something like, let's say, median, you can see how that shot is going slightly brighter and slightly darker based on the sample shot. And this is an obvious difference between, say, grading this shot to be a more orange that, you know, is like the fire, and actually using the fire to grade the shot. It makes the shot much more alive, and it's almost as if she's actually been shot in the same location that the fire is, you know, happening, or where a fire is happening. So a lot more useful. Now, if you wanted to take this even further, what you could do is choose the diffuse color sampling method. And it may not be totally noticeable at first because we have this blur option and it's set to 300. Watch what happens when I bring this down to zero. So now we're actually compositing the sample shot over the top and we're blurring it. So if I just decrease that blur, put a little bit in but not too much, now you can see we're actually seeing the sample footage reflected in the shots. There's also some flip options that are available when you have this. I'm just going to turn that to zero. I can flip on the X, which actually looks quite good with her, doesn't it? Particularly good with her. I can flip on the Y, and I can flip on the XY. And usability-wise, this will make a lot more sense when we look at the 3D model. But I really like that diffuse color option, and it's the one I use the most. I'm going to bring that back up to 300. If we take a look at this last option, Fluoro Bubble, this is just a very bright background, created courtesy of a beautiful Sapphire S Effect preset. I'm going to turn it off, but I'm going to actually sample it. So select my footage, and I'm going to choose that as the sample layer, Fluoro Bubble. So this will be really obvious now because we've got a lot of bright colors changing. I'll just turn the fire off for a moment. So now you can see we're going green and pink, and that's using the diffuse option. If I was to choose something like average for that, then that basically is going to average out the colors of this background, which is not as effective. It's not too bad because we do get some big areas of green occasionally, but when we've got this mixture of blue and pink and green, we kind of get a sort of, you know, mixed color. So if I was to choose diffuse color, then it's very obvious because it's overlaying over the top. And once again, we could bring that blur down like that. I could even bring it right down and just have a little reflect, little echo of that background on there. All right, so that's the basics of Color Link. Now let's just take a look at a few other examples. And this first one is for the shot where you really want to make it feel like it's in the background. So we've got the same talent here on this gray background, and I've just masked it out so it sort of sits in this nice sapphire background. And let's use Color Link to make her feel as if she's, you know, more integrated into this background. So I will apply Color Link. And first thing we'll do is we will sample the background. Ah, already it's looking better, right? So once again, you'd go in and just check the different sample methods. Maybe that's a little better, median. As I said, I often like to use diffuse color. Let's go straight into diffuse. And we can try different blend modes. Overlay is very strong, but once again, you could go in and you could color correct that. Now, because we're using diffuse color, we could bring that blur down and we could, you know, drop that over the top a little bit like that. So we're starting to see a little bit of the background in there like that. That's interesting as well. We could try different flip options. That doesn't make a lot of sense with this because it's, you know, we want it to be feel like it's part of this background. Although that actually looks quite nice, doesn't it? Because now the movement of the part that's been sampled is moving in a different direction. Always discovering something new with this software. Now, one thing I would like to do with this though is try a little bit of film glow. So I'm going to enable film glow. And by default, this will make the shot itself glow. It doesn't work particularly well here, but what I want to do is I want to glow from the alpha, and I want to glow under the source like that. And then I can sample a color from in here like that, okay? So you've got a lot of settings in here for the film glow, and there's even a secondary glow option as well that you can use. So these are terrifically useful settings taken from BCC Plus's film glow effect. That's probably a little strong, so just bring that down a little bit. Like that. You know, I might even want to, feather her mask a little bit here in After Effects. Something like that. So you can use Color Link to better integrate a shot into a background. Now, the next most logical thing to look at is green screen, because talking about integrating something into a background, obviously you key someone out or something out, and then you put it onto a different background and you want it to feel as if it is part of that background. And this is where Color Link can help. In this example, we've got the talent and we've used BCC Plus's Denoise ML machine learning just to remove some of the noise, and also BCC Primate Studio to key her out. So beautiful keying job there by our very own Ben. And I've got some backgrounds in here. I've got a range of different backgrounds. I've just put them in a pre-comp to make it a little easier. The one at the end here is that colorful one we just saw a moment ago. And that's the only one that's dynamic. So let's use Color Link. So select the footage again. And I'll just apply Color Link. All right, so at the moment, it's using itself as a sample method. So she's obviously gone very green. So I'll choose green screen backgrounds. So now, depending on the background that she's on, she's using the average sample method. Sample type is set to dynamic. These are still shots, of course, so it wouldn't matter whether we chose static or dynamic, except for the very end shot. So as I move into these different or above these different backgrounds, you can see how now she's a little more red. Now she's a little more purple. And here, a little more orange. And finally here, she's at the moment using average, so she's sort of an average of that background. But if I chose diffuse color, now she's going to be a lot more integrated into that background. You can see there's a little more yellow as yellow's behind her. And of course, I can adjust the blur. Not too much with this particular shot. And here's where the flip option could work quite well. So if I flipped on the X, now we're not necessarily getting the color that is behind her on top of her. If we just bring the blur right down, you can see we've got pink there where there's blue behind her. I could flip on the Y and I could choose an option there. And the reason I like this is because, bring it back up to 300. She could be in a room where she's got these colorful lights all around her. And if we were to use this option without flip, it doesn't look quite as realistic as if we'd used one of the flip options where she's, the light from something that's in front of her is reflecting on her. So that's why we included the flip options with this. We'll have a look at that with the 3D model in a moment as well. But this really is effective with dynamic backgrounds, especially ones that change a lot on green screen footage. All right, so let's finish up by taking a look at how you could use Color Link with a 3D model and some text. So I've got this little animation of some AirPods. I'm here in After Effects, of course. I've imported a 3D model. And obviously it's AirPods, it's very white. And we've got this beautiful colored background. So I want to integrate this a little better. And what better way to do that than to use Color Link? So let's walk through this. So for the sample layer, we're going to choose background. We've already started to get a bit of color there. It's a little muddy. So next thing to do would be to try different sample methods. Just go through here. I mean, that's very bright blue. Not really working with this. So I'm just going to go straight down to diffuse color. Okay. And that's already starting to look better. I want this to feel as if this background is more like a 360 degree background and it's being reflected in the object. So what we can do is, let's see, come down and try different blend modes next. Say overlay is not bad. Starting to feel a little better there now. Let's try adding a little bit of film glow. So once again, I will take the glow from the alpha and bring the glow under the source and sample, I don't know, maybe this blue. There we go. And bring the intensity down in something like that. What if we tried something like multiply? Well, that's pretty strong. How about we reduce the blur? There we go. Something like that. This is obviously a very, very strong color, you know, color grade. Let's go into our color correct and enable that and bring up the brightness a bit. It works quite well with this, doesn't it? The brightness. Contrast, we don't need to play around with too much. And we've got this power light on top, which actually is quite effective too. You see, it's a separate layer. And this is where we really could be helped by Flip, okay? You can see how we've got the blue there behind that, because if we bring our blur down, I'm gonna make sure I'm on the right layer. If we bring our blur right down, which actually looks quite good like that, it's kind of the illusion's, you know, somewhat ruined by it being obviously the same background that's comped on top. So this is where Flip really works. I'm going to choose Flip X. Aha. What about Flip Y? That's pretty good too. So obviously it's very strong. I'll bring that back down like that. And we've got, you know, quite an interesting integration in there. Inside the AirPod comp, I've also got some text. I'm just going to turn that on. And just some light gray text in there. You can see how that affects the text as well. Okay, so you can use it with models, use it with text. A really quick way to integrate text and models into backgrounds. Bring that blur down a bit. That's looking terrific. And of course, we have a drop shadow. If you wanted to have that just sit up from the background a bit, you could always add a bit of a drop shadow as well. Okay, that's pretty much specifically in there for text. All right, so hopefully that's given you a good idea about how you can use Color Link to save time and get creative when combining your layers together. To learn more about Continuum 2024.5 and Color Link, visit borisfx.com, where you can also download a free trial version. For now, this is John. I'll see you in the next tutorial.